Hey everybody, my name is Trey Greenwood, and today we're going to do a little forecast discussion on this pretty potent winter storm that is slated to impact much of the country from the Southern Plains all the way up through the northeastern tip of the U.S. And it's actually already begun for some of these spots from the Southern Plains up into the Midwest. You can see in the pink here, we've got winter storm warnings stretching all the way from New Mexico up into New York and Vermont, surrounded by the blue areas, which are winter storm watches. So, pretty large portion of the country going to be under the gun for this winter storm. So, wanted to do a little discussion on what's going on now, why we're going to see this winter storm, and just what you can expect for your area. So, let's go ahead and get started here. Let's take a look at what's going on currently in our radar view here. So, if we go down to the Southern Plains, we've got snow ongoing in the Texas Panhandle and some semblance of wintry mix down here into far northern Texas. And to the south of that, we've got rain down toward the Abilene area. And right now, Dallas-Fort Worth is in the clear. But later on this afternoon and into the evening hours and overnight, the Dallas-Fort Worth area going to be under the gun for some winter precipitation. We'll talk about that in a second. As we go up toward the northeast into Missouri, we've already seen heavy snow in a lot of places, particularly up in northern Missouri, western Illinois, particularly in Quincy, Illinois, area surrounding that. By 7 a.m. Central Time this morning, that area had already gathered about 8 to 12 inches of snow, with quite a bit more on the way. You can see here down towards St. Louis, these red colors represent sort of a wintry mix, not quite pure snow, a little bit of perhaps freezing rain in there as well. Whereas these blue colors indicate snow, pure snowfall, and the green indicates rain. And if we go continue off toward the northeast, we'll go to the Indianapolis radar. Quite a bit of rain ongoing here across the southern half of Indiana, with some snow up toward the northern half of Indiana. So that's kind of what's going on right now. This winter storm is just getting started. We've got plenty more winter precipitation on the way for first the Southern Plains into the Midwest, and then that'll move off into the Northeast come Thursday and Friday. So let's give you a little bit of a scientific overview, just basic scientific overview, why we're seeing what we're seeing with this winter storm. So this is the wind up at about 18,000 feet in the atmosphere. And you can see this big old dip in the jet stream right here. These winds are really kind of dipping down. And you can see these contours dip down all the way down into the Baja Peninsula there in Mexico. Well, that's our what's called a long wave trough. And that's what's really providing the energy for this system. Think of it as the engine of a car. This long wave trough provides the overall mechanism that we need to allow air to rise. And when air rises, we get storms and a lot of precipitation. Now, if we go down in the atmosphere a little bit, we'll go back toward about 10,000 feet. You can see these smaller little kinks in the flow, these little dips in the flow. These are called shortwave troughs, and these are little mini engines within the broader scale, bigger sort of engine. And when you get these little shortwaves, it helps concentrate that energy within the broader scale piece of energy. And when you get these little shortwaves, you can often see enhanced precipitation ahead of these. And you can see that this one right here, that I've outlined here in blue, right over Missouri, that's what has caused this heavy snowfall this morning and what continues to fuel that snowfall through parts of Missouri into Illinois and Indiana. And we're going to see a few more of these start to rotate into the southern plains as we get toward the afternoon. You can see one trailing back here down into western Mexico. That's going to move off into the plains and going to be a little bit of a boost of energy and allow some heavy snow and ice to start falling in places like central and southern Oklahoma, northern and central Texas, up into Arkansas this afternoon and evening into the overnight hours. So let's go ahead and go through some model data here, kind of show you what's going on first with the surface pattern. So these blues and pinks and whites are our cold air, and these greens and yellows and oranges are our warm air. And the boundary between those is our cold front, which stretches up pretty much toward the Great Lakes region all the way down into the southern plains, toward the Texas South Plains there. And this cold front is going to continue to sag to the south as we go through the day today. That cold air is really going to push toward the south as we go on through the day today, as you can see here. But now let's go to about 5,000 feet off the ground. And you'll notice that where we see this cold air near the surface, the temperatures at about 5,000 feet are going to be above freezing. These greens and blues and yellows are above freezing, whereas these pinks and blues and whites are below freezing. So when we have this air, this warmer air that's above freezing, above a layer of sub-freezing air near the surface, that is where we're going to see the best potential for ice and impacts from ice, freezing rain, and sleet. Whereas to the north, where the temperature is below freezing throughout the entire atmosphere, that's where we're going to see purely snow. So wherever this cold air, however far south this cold air surges, and however far north this layer of warm air aloft goes, that's going to modulate where we're going to see the best chances for freezing rain and sleet and impacts from ice. So if this layer of warm air aloft does not go quite as far inland, then we won't see, we'll see better chances for freezing rain and sleet farther south. Whereas if this layer of warm air aloft goes a little bit farther inland, farther to the north, then we'll see a better chance for areas farther north to see freezing rain, which would bring places like Oklahoma City and Tulsa in play for ice. Right now, these models are pretty much showing that this warm air aloft is going to stay off a little bit to the south, probably somewhere just to the southeast of the I-44 corridor in Oklahoma, but still remains to be seen. And let's take a look at some of the model forecast for precipitation here. This is the North American model, fresh off the morning run here. So you'll notice it's got our precipitation, our heavy snow and ice out here toward Missouri, Illinois, Indiana. And then not much for the southern plains yet, but that continues to fill in as we go on toward the afternoon and early evening here in the southern plains. So these reds and purples right here, that's where our swath of potential freezing rain is going to be. And you can see Oklahoma City right on the edge of that. But places like Dallas, Fort Worth, Gainesville, Denton, down toward the I-20 corridor near Abilene, are definitely in play this afternoon and evening for potential impacts from freezing rain and sleet. Whereas farther to the north, where this is purely blue, that's where we're going to see purely snow. So places like the Texas Panhandle, northwest Oklahoma, southwest Kansas, purely snow for you this afternoon. And to the south of this boundary, toward the San Antonio, Austin area, Waco, purely rain for the most part this afternoon and evening. But as we go on through the overnight hours, radar continues to fill in, and this swath of potential ice continues to fill in all the way up towards southern Illinois, southern Missouri, down towards southeast Oklahoma, and even down now toward the I-20 corridor, still toward Abilene, and even a little bit farther south. Chance for pretty significant ice accumulation in those spots, whereas places like Oklahoma City, Tulsa, Springfield, Missouri, St. Louis, it'll be purely snow for you as that cold air plunges to the south into the overnight hours tonight. We'll continue on here with time. You can see that swath of ice maintains itself, moves off a little bit to the east. So places like Little Rock, Memphis, Paducah, Kentucky, southern Indiana, towards Cincinnati, Ohio, that swath of ice will maintain itself as it moves off to the east Thursday morning, with areas of snow to the north and rain to the south. And then by Thursday evening, we'll see places like the upper Midwest into the northeast up toward New York State start to get in on that ice and snow. And then by Friday evening, Friday afternoon and evening, things start to move out pretty nicely for us up in the northeast. So let's go to the GFS model here. This is just another potential outcome for us, and pretty much showing the same thing as the NAM. By this evening, we get to see this swath of ice here down toward the I-20 corridor, Dallas-Fort Worth, with snow to the north, Oklahoma City, mostly snow there. And that continues, that swath of ice continues to fill in, those reds and purples there up toward Ohio, all the way down into central Texas by the overnight hours Thursday. And then we move on, pretty much the same as the NAM. The swath of ice continues here, places like Memphis up toward Louisville, Kentucky, up to the northeast. and then things start to move out by a Saturday evening. So a lot of folks are going to be under the gun here over the next couple of days with this storm. Once again, all of the areas in pink here are winter storm warnings. So that includes places like Oklahoma City, Tulsa, Wichita, down toward Dallas, even down toward Austin, just to the north of the San Antonio metro area, and then up toward Little Rock, Springfield, Missouri, St. Louis, Indianapolis, Cincinnati, Columbus, up toward Buffalo, and Rochester, New York. All of those areas under winter storm warnings, which it does include the threat for heavy snow as well as ice accumulations with that as well. This purple area here, once again, is an ice storm warning. So places like Memphis, up toward Paducah, Louisville, Lexington, Kentucky, you are under an ice storm warning. So the chance for crippling ice, significant ice accumulation is there within that area, but also does stretch down perhaps toward the Dallas-Fort Worth metro area, places like Little Rock, and then up towards Cincinnati and Columbus as well. And then let's take a look at a couple of more products here just to close things off. This is the HREF, which is an ensemble model system. So it takes into account multiple different models. And this is the 24-hour snowfall that's averaged out among all the different models going from this morning at 6 a.m. Central Standard Time through tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. Central Standard Time. And you can see down here, this scale is in inches. So places like Oklahoma City, probably 4 to 6 inches or so, down toward Northwest Texas, 4 to 6 inches as well, with locally higher amounts. And then places like St. Louis, up toward Northern Indiana, where a bunch of snow has already fallen and continues to fall. Once things are all said and done, you may see an additional maybe 8 to 10 inches from this storm, maybe even higher. So once things are all said and done, you'll see maybe even 2 feet of snow on the ground in some places up there. And then the ice threat does exist as well. If we go to our potential for freezing rain over the next 24-hour period, starting at 6 a.m. Central Standard Time this morning, you can see places like southeast Oklahoma toward the Dallas-Fort Worth metro area at highest risk, and that will translate off to the east and northeast toward areas like Memphis, southern Illinois, southern Indiana, into Ohio tomorrow into late tomorrow into early Friday as well. So one more thing here. This is the winter storm severity index for the U.S. from the Weather Prediction Center. Areas in pink with the highest threat for extreme impacts here. So Memphis down toward Little Rock, even then down toward Dallas, as well as places like northern Indiana up toward Indianapolis there, with the highest threat for extensive and widespread severe property damage, particularly from ice, perhaps heavy snowfall as well. So anywhere in these oranges and yellows and reds need to be prepared for a period of heavy snow and potentially ice, but these areas in pink here are at highest risk for potentially crippling winter storm impacts. So that's all we have for now. If you're in these areas here, if you're in the pink areas in particular, take your precautions. If you haven't done so already, do them as quickly as possible. Snow has already started to pile up in places like northeast Missouri, western Illinois, as well as the Texas Panhandle. And that will only continue to fill in here as the afternoon and evening moves on today into tomorrow. Places, again, like Oklahoma City, Dallas-Fort Worth, Little Rock, Memphis, up toward the northeast, the threat for heavy snow, as well as some significant ice accumulation that could impact travel significantly, is in play. So if you're in these pink areas in particular, take your precautions now if you haven't done so already. But that's all we have for now. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.